Dorgon into believing that he's a saint.
Hello, my name is Doreen. I am the head maid. My master Orgon has been totally fooled by Tartuffe.
Indeed.
Why can't Orgon see Tartuffe's deceit?
I don't know. All I know is that it has to stop, and soon,
before it's too late.
Now look at him.
This Tartuffe seemed to have quite turned Orgon's head.
chummy with Tartuffe. He will not say a word or even blow his nose without asking him first.
He is Father's sole confidant and trusted advisor on things, and Father gives him money.
And gifts and more food than I've seen any other human being devour. Tartuffe stuffs himself at the master's table, and when he grunts and belches, we all say, God bless and keep you, Moliere Tartuffe.
I wonder if he has anything to do with delaying Marion and Valor's engagement.
Father won't let anyone hiccup. Now let's get engaged without Tartuffe's approval.
Poor Miss Marianne. She cannot even read a book without Tartuffe approving of the title. She may as well be trapped in a convent.
I see Father coming out. Talk to him, Cleante. He knows you're a man of reason and he likes you. You're the only hope for my sister.
I'll try and explain to him.
Thank you, Cleante.
The master could use a good talking to, that's for sure. But what he really needs is to be de-Tartuffe-ized.
My dear brother-in-law.
Welcome back to Paris. Your trip to the country went well?
Ah, the country! It really isn't all it's cracked up to me. How anxious I was to get back home.
Well, now that you're here, perhaps we can have a little talk.
Of course, my dear fiance. But first, I must relieve my mind about the family. Dorian, how things been here the last few days? Is everyone well?
Actually, the mistress was ill yesterday. It started off as a headache, but soon she had dizzy spells and collapsed at breakfast. The servants had to carry her to her room, and the doctor soon came to leave her.
Of course. But what of Tartuffe?
Tartuffe? Healthy as an ox, he finished the mistress with breakfast and called for a second round of bacon.
Poor fellow.
By evening, the mistress was able to sit up on her own, and the chef brought her some weak tea and broth, which seemed to help somewhat.
Yes, yes. But what of Tartuffe?
Well, he outdid himself at supper and polished off three partridges and a leg of mutton.
Poor fellow.
I sat up with your wife while she tossed and turned until dawn.
But what of Tartuffe?
Well, after drinking four cups of refined Bordeaux, he passed out in the salon and slept all night to round the chandeliers.
Poor fellow.
The rest of the household is well enough, though our ears are still ringing from a visit by your mother. Now, if you'll excuse me, I will go tell the mistress you are here, and how you are worried sick over her health.
I fear that servant is lacking in form, and rightfully so, I might add. The way you have let that man alter your behavior is nothing short of alarming.
I don't know who you're talking about, Cleante.
Monsieur Tartuffe.
Ah, now there's a man, Cleante. Yet, Tartuffe is more than a man. He is a glowing symbol of truth and righteousness that only philosophers in their wisest moments could imagine. He's made a profound impact on my life, I can tell you.
Yes, I can see that.
Tartuffe is teaching me to forego the petty concerns of this material world and embrace higher things. I am learning to loosen the bonds of human ties. Why, I could watch my own wife and children all perish, and still I have the strength to live on.
A touching sentiment.
Tartuffe is the most venerable of men. He prays, he teaches, he loves mankind, and yet cares little for his own comfort. Why, just the other day, I found him in tears, right in this very room.
Tears?
Yes. I asked him what was the matter, and he told me that during his morning prayers, in a moment of unkindness, he had killed a flea that was biting his scalp.
You're saying this made me laugh. Are you not saying it's a joke?
Oh, Cleante, I don't think I could ever joke again. Tartuffe has shown me the way to a zealous life.
Then it is true. You have lost your reason.
On the contrary. I finally found it.
Has it ever occurred to you, Orgon, that perhaps some of this sanctimonious behavior of Tartuffe may be just for show?
I'd rather doubt that the sun rises each morning. I know the difference between deceit and truthing.
I wonder. People who are truly devout, those whose souls are as pure and unselfish as you say, never had to have to advertise the fact to others. Those of a modest heart, wait, no, the virtuous ones are silent and make the world a better place. Your Monsieur Tartuffe does not sound like this at all. He has alienated you from your family. What good could come out of such a thing?
Are you quite finished?
Oh, I suppose so. You obviously are not in reasoning mood these days.
Well, you suggest that Tartuffe is sacrilege and heresy. Tartuffe and I will have to pray for you.
You are
Moliere?
Yes, he's quite an amazing fellow.
You really think so, Father?
I praise God for sending him to us.
Oh, Father, you'll make me so happy.
Yes, I had trouble imagining that any man would be good enough for my daughter. But then he came into our lives, and I saw the light.
Just wait till I tell Valère.
Valère? Who's Valère?
Why, my fiancé, Father.
Oh, him. Are you still thinking about him? No. We must talk again of Tartuffe.
Tartuffe?
Yes. It is true he's a bit older than you, but he's willing to overlook the fact, God bless him.
My ears must be playing tricks on me. I thought you said something about marrying Tartuffe.
Your ears are just fine. What do you think we've been talking about?
That's a good one.
You again?
I could not help but laugh out loud. I just heard such a funny joke of how sweet Mary is to marry that decrepit scoundrel Tartuffe.
This is none of your business, Doreen.
Oh, but I like a good laugh just as much as the next person.
This is not a laughing matter. I decided that Marion is to wed Tartuffe. He's become one of our family and made Marion a dutiful and reverent husband.
You're such a tease, Master.
Stop that! I'm in earnest!
It's no use denying it, Master. We see right through you, you sly prankster, you.
I cannot stand this. If you cannot hold your tongue while I speak to my daughter, then leave the room.
I will hold my tongue, but I'm still thinking.
Now, I know Tartuffe is not the handsomest of men.
Ha!
You spoke!
It was a cough. Go on.
And it is true he's a bit older than you.
That being polite.
What did you say?
I was talking to myself, pay no attention.
I indeed won't. Now, to show you how very humble Tartuffe is, he did not even have the boldness to ask for your hand.
How romantic.
I cannot stand this! I'm willing to become a patient and forgiving man like Tartuffe, but you have all put me in such a bad humor that I must go to the garden and pray before I lose my temper.
Have you lost your tongue, Marianne?
I was in shock. What could I say? I thought he was talking about Valère, and then I was to marry Tartuffe, and I went mute.
You could say, "Dear Father, I'd rather not," or, "Tartuffe? I don't think so, Daddy," or, "How about, no?"
I thought he was talking about Valère.
That's nice. Well, I'm sure you'll be very happy, Mademoiselle Tartuffe. Such a romantic fellow to boot. I think it's so cute how the hair going out of his nose matches the hair growing out of his ears.
Oh, Doreen, help me. You know how stubborn Father could be? And ever since that Tartuffe came to live with us, he's gotten even worse.
What I suggest is for you to talk it over with Valère. Ah, just like an actor, right on cue.
Hurry up, my love.
Valère, such a pretty picture. It ought to be embroidered on a pillow.
I've just come from Fiante. Is there some obstacle to our marriage? In fact, he told me that he would not be surprised if your father had changed his mind and wants you to wed Monsieur Tartuffe.
Cleante guessed correctly. As far as father's concerned, I am now engaged to Tartuffe.
And what is your mind on the matter?
Well, that is to say, what do you advise?
Me? Well, it is not my place to have you go against your own father's wishes.
No?
I mean, if the arrangement suits you, then who am I to say no to it?
You want me to marry Tartuffe?
I didn't say that. I meant that the proposal's all appealing to you. Who am I to say no to it?
This is choice. He has even less sense than she does.
I see now that you could not have loved me very much to even suggest such a thing.
It is quite clear your love for me must have been pretty feeble, or you would not have been in such a dilemma over whom to marry.
Should I stop this now, or wait and see who wins the stupidity contest?
Well, I thank you for your advice. I'm sure I'll be very happy in the arms of Tartuffe.
You are welcome. I'm only too glad to have a girl who doesn't know her own heart.
Just so you know that it's you who've driven me to this, good day.
Call me at any time in a similar quandary.
Did you say something?
Certainly not. Did you?
Not a word.
Then I'll say something. What's the matter with you two? I know lovers are a bit soft in the head, but you two take the cake.
I must go.
Go then.
Marianne, this boy is in love with you, and you know it.
Then why does he want me to marry Tartuffe so bad?
He does not want you to marry anyone but himself. And as for you, Valère, this woman is so head over heels in love with you, she trips over furniture at the mention of your name.
Why was she so ready to give me up?
Because you did not fly into a rage at the mention of her marrying Tartuffe. Women like that sort of thing. Remember that for the future. Now, before I say anything else, I want you to make up and whatever. Go on.
Well. Oh, my dearest.
Such a pretty picture. It might make a better tapestry than a pillow.
Doreen, help me get out of this terrible engagement with Tartuffe.
Yes, Doreen, advise him and be grateful forever.
What I suggest is for you to pretend to go along with this engagement.
What?
In the meantime, you, Valère, must not be seen in Marianne's company. Instead, you and your friend see what you can dig up about this Tartuffe. I suspect he's wormed his way into other households in the past. See what you can find, and we'll use it to expose this girl.
So, Doreen.
Meanwhile, Marianne and I will work on the master from this end. He's got to come to a sense of eventually, but I think he'll need a little help. Quick, someone's coming. You go that way, you the other way.
I sweep the stairs, Marianne. Oh, Valère, my love.
Enough, we've already done the makeup scene.
Safely back to us.
Yes, a fine fix you'd be in if he had not returned.
Doreen, you should best attend to Marianne. She is somewhat upset for reasons I think you understand.
Yes, madame, the poor thing.
God save your troubled soul, Doreen, and lead you on the road to grace.
Thanks, may you soon hit the road yourself.
Monsieur Tartuffe, may I speak with you for a moment?
Certainly, my good madame, but first, may I say how overjoyed I am to see you looking so healthy.
Thank you.
After seeing how weak and ill you were yesterday, I prayed for your rapid recovery all night. How blessed that my humble prayers were answered.
Yes. Come in and sit down. What I have to say is very important.
Yes. Please sit. I will not have you exerting yourself for all the world. Your health, madame, is more precious to me than my own. I would sooner be racked by a painful illness than have you experience the slightest discomfort.
That is pursuing Christian charity to the extreme. But I thank you for the kind thought. Now that we are alone, I wish to speak freely.
How I have longed for this moment, madame. There are so many people in this household that I have yet to find myself alone with you. And now that the time has come, I wish to talk intimately with you about your soul.
I wish you were squeezing my hand as you type.
My sincerest apologies. My fervor gets the best of me, and my fervor for madame is immense.
What is your hand doing there?
I am just checking to see if the material is substantial enough. I will not have you catching a cold.
It tickles. I don't like to be tickled. Now the reason I wish to speak to you.
How well you look today.
So you already mentioned.
Simply ravishing. I should go down on my hands and knees right now. Praise God for such a beautiful picture.
I'd rather you didn't at the moment. Now concerning the business, my daughter, Marianne. I heard this morning that my father wishes to break his promise to Valère and give Marianne to you.
I heard something to that effect, but it is not the daughter that interests me. is her mother.
Well, I am already married, so that brings us back to...
Do not think I have a heart made of stone, because I pursue the perfection of the soul does not mean I'm incapable of ardent passion. For when I first saw you, madame, I knew I was a man like other men, and that all the virtue in the world could not keep me from desiring you. I tried to avoid your sight, hoping that by taking the object of my desire, I could focus on my salvation. But I was too weak to combat the tides of passion that overcame my heart. I yearned for the day when I could have but one moment alone with you.
I understand, but aren't you afraid that I might turn around and tell my husband of this pretty little speech you have made? Don't you fear that your friendship might be a bit strained if he knew such a passion for his wife?
Madame, you would never betray our love, for I know the flame burns intensely in you as it does within me.
I'm sorry to disappoint you, Mr. Tartuffe, but there is no flame. In fact, I am the one with the heart of stone when it comes to you. But do not fear, I will say nothing to my husband if you tell him you have no wish to marry my daughter, and encourage for Marianne and Bellaire to wed as soon as possible. What do you say to such a deal?
No! His luxury must be known!
Dennis!
I was listening from the other room. I heard everything. He must have followed everything. You must tell him what type of flim-flam he has brought into his house.
Be quiet, Dennis. I will handle this my way. Nothing will be said to Orgon, and Tartuffe will see to it that Marianne and Bellaire...
This swindler has fooled Father long enough. If you don't tell Father, I will.
You must not, Damus. It is better this way.
Oh, here you all are. Tartuffe, I've been looking for you.
Father, I have something to tell you.
No, he doesn't. Come, Damus.
This man, whom you value so dearly, has repaid your friendship in the most discreet manner by showing his passion to your wife. It'd be very disrespectful for me to not tell you.
Dear Orgon, I didn't want to bother you with such a trivial thing. I can handle myself. A woman knows how to handle these kinds of tricky situations. I would much rather have the whole episode been kept from you. But Damus has evidently thought otherwise. That is all I have to say on the matter.
Great heavens! Tartuffe! Can all they say be true?
Yes, brother. All of it is true. I'm a guilty sinner whose iniquity is shameful. In fact, I'm the most accursed wretch in this whole world. There is no limit to my wickedness. I deny nothing. Punish me as you see fit. Cast me out as you are justified in doing. Spare me not a drop of your anger or wrath. I need your forgiveness.
You wicked scoundrel! You dare to sling mud on the most spotless reputation on God's earth? Aren't you? Your false accusations are useless against such a holy person.
This hypocrite has one good eye in his minutes.
Not another word from your slanderous lips.
I pray you, brother, let the boy speak. His accusations are, however, from the heart. Surely you must trust the word of your own flesh and blood than those of a stranger. I might seem to be a virtuous man, but do not be fooled by appearances. Underneath, I am a great sinner who has been found out. Speak on, my boy. Please call me deceitful, for it is true. You may also call me a thief and a murderer, and I will not contradict you. On my knees, I accept the consequences of my villainy.
Tartuffe! You go too far in your godliness. Aren't you ashamed of yourself? Your false accusations are pointless against such a virtuous person.
But the man is as wicked as that he admits.
Aren't you ashamed of yourself? I demand you apologize to this man immediately.
Apologize, but...
Apologize, or I'll take a stick to you.
No, brother. I pray you, on my knees, you should beat him instead.
Get up! Apologize!
This shyster!
Apologize! But I don't need to take a stick to you, my boy. Instead, I disown you. You will be cut off without a penny. Now see where your tricks have led. As for your sister, I will see her married to Tartuffe before the week is out.
I'll go, but...
No exit speech! Scram! Be gone! I'll show them what comes of insulting a living saint!
Dear brother, I fear my presence here has only brought guilt to the family. I will leave immediately. With the object of their derision gone, you can be reconciled to them once again.
Leave? You cannot! I need you, Tartuffe! My very life depends on it!
After I am gone, you will learn to live without me. Everything will be better then.
But I want you to become my heir!
What?
I was serious when I said I would disinherit my son. You are my son now, a greater son than I had before. I wish to leave all my money and property to you, my dear Tartuffe.
I cannot accept such a generous gift.
There's nothing for you to accept. I'll sign everything over to you, whether you like it or not. Now come upstairs.
But I fear this will make them hate me all the more.
Good, come on.
And your wife, she'll be so uncomfortable with me around.
Good, serves her right. In fact, I insist the two of you spend more time together. That will annoy her, I'll bet. Can't wait to see the looks on their faces when I announce...
Brother?
Yes, sir, dear?
I believe I see God's hand in this.
Amen.
Then I was so worried about my husband finding out, but things
close to me, my dear self.
Well, I don't wish to appear bold or immodest, but when I realized your passion for me was as great as which I had for you, I quite lost sight of it, though. It's a weakness, I know, and you must abhor weakness in a woman.
No, I like it. It's very becoming in a certain woman. In fact, it makes my heart beat all the faster. Do you hear it?
I will believe you, but then I shall trust anything you say. My dear, sweet Tartuffe.
You are not just trying to humor me, are you? I know you want me to break off my engagement with Marianne. Is this your way of-
Marry anyone you want, dear, as long as you save your love to me and only me.
My own life. I'll prove my love for you. Now, this very moment.
You impetuous boy.
You seem to have a bad cough, madam.
Oh, it's nothing. It is going to stop any second now. Yes, it'd be best if it stopped any second now.
You are beautiful and desirable, even when you cough.
Thank you. No one's ever told me that before.
What are you doing?
Oh, doing? Let's see. The cough is gone.
Why are you rapping on the table?
Oh, just for good luck. Not what
they say. We do not need good luck. We have better than luck. We have your fool of a husband on our side.
My husband.
Was there ever a more credulous idiot than Oregon? I can tell him the sun is the moon and he'll believe me. Such a simple-minded oaf, but I'll make him forget all about him. My dearest.
Mother. And what's more, he's taken some old letters I was hiding for a friend.
Oh, dear Fountain, what are we to do?
It seems the next move is Tartuffe's. With the power he has now, he can do just about anything he pleases.
Then he shall do the most godlike thing. The man is a saint, I tell you.
Listen to her, still defending that scallywag.
Mother, the man alienated the affections of my family, tried to wed my daughter, nearly kissed my wife, and got control of all my money and property.
The ways of righteousness are always not clear.
My poor master. Now you know what it's like to come up against someone who has been totally hoodwinked by Tartuffe. Nothing can be more frustrating.
Well, one good thing has come of all of this. Our family is once more in agreement.
Tartuffe is a saint, I tell you.
All except one. Tartuffe may have driven our family apart once, but he cannot again.
Yes, my son. Can you ever forgive me?
Yes, father. And to prove it, I challenge that Tartuffe to a duel!
Calm yourself, Davis.
Although you may not inherit the riches a son deserves, in my heart, you're my one and true son.
Thank you, father.
And Mary, you are to wed Valer as originally planned. If you'll take her without dowry, that is. I have nothing to offer.
Valer loved Marianne. He was never interested in her money.
That is true. This very moment, he is using his connections at the court to try and stop Tartuffe.
I fear it may be too late. Any moment now, it may get worse than the swindler.
Is the master of the house present?
Uh-oh. Here it comes.
What business do you have with him?
Legal business, the only kind I deal with.
I am the man you seek.
Look how he smiles so humbly. Maybe he owes Orgon money.
I come on behalf of Monsieur Tartuffe.
Wrong again, madame.
Tell our master Tartuffe I challenge him to a duel!
Go gentle, Davis.
The boy was only joking.
I don't handle duels. You'll have to speak to Monsieur Tartuffe in person about that. I only handle legal documents.
And what, pray, is your name, sir?
I am Monsieur Loyal. It is an old family name dating back to the Normans. We have always been lawyers in my family.
That does not seem like anything to smile about.
I smile because I like my dog.
At least an executioner covers his face when he works.
Easy, my boy.
What have you to say to me, Monsieur Loyal?
I here have a writ, witnessed and validated at the court this very day. It says you, your family, and furniture must vacate this house by tomorrow morning.
What?
It cannot be true.
Madame Jarabox sees the light.
It's
by tomorrow morning.
Yes, it seemed Monsieur Tartuffe wished the writ to be effective immediately, but the court, owing to your good name and reputation, insisted that you have more time.
I see. It is as I most feared.
As you well know, this house now belongs to Monsieur Tartuffe, and he wishes to occupy it as soon as possible. As for your investments and other funds, they have been duly signed over to his name, and he has taken possession of them today.
Does that include thrashing you, young sir?
Indeed it does, young sir.
How about if I took a crack at him?
I am happy to report the law applies to women as equally as men.
It might just be worth it to smack that smug smile off his face.
If you have nothing else to say, Mr. Loyal, it might be best if you left.
If you think so. I'm never in a hurry to leave. I guess that is because I love my job so much. Good day to you all.
I never trusted that Tartuffe.
Never trusted him, no.
Listen to her.
He was too serious in his position.
Too serious, much too serious.
And his eyes were too close together.
Too close, much too close.
My instincts about people are always accurate, and I knew from the start, the moment I set eyes on Tartuffe.
Mother, go home. You'll all be out on the street tomorrow. Come visit us then.
It's all your fault if you realize.
Goodbye, Mother.
But only listen to you instead of.
McJane!
What is it?
Shut up!
No, hi. Mother, wrong way.
If I had a penny to my name, I'd leave a legacy to that supposer.
Dear Orgon, all is not lost. We have each other. That's more than what we had when Tartuffe set us against one another.
It is true, Father. Oh, my dear child. Can you ever forgive me? I've been so foolish.
Oh, Papa.
Well, things have gone as bad as they can, I'd say.
Don't go saying that. It's like asking for more trouble.
Thank goodness you all gathered together. There's no time to lose.
Valer!
Celeste!
What is it, McCoy?
Not very good news, I'm afraid.
Didn't I tell you?
What is it?
A very close friend of mine was at the court trying to find out more about Tartuffe.
Well, in comes the hypocrite with letters that he insists on showing the king.
Oh, goodness! The letters!
I don't understand. What are these letters?
They're treasonous! They disparage the crown and criticize the government. I'll sign them for a friend and foolishly took them to Tartuffe.
Tartuffe now says the letters are yours and has announced your family to the king himself. A warrant for your arrest is issued, and officers are on the way to apprehend you all.
Monstrous!
I challenge the officer to a duel!
Calm yourself, Davis! This Tartuffe surpasses even himself.
There's no time to waste. I have a carriage at the back entrance. We must all flee immediately. I scrapped together all the money I could for your journey.
Give no reason to rush off. We have come to offer you free lodging in the king's prison.